Hello guys, this is some info about a new version of RTML Exporter for PlayKnight 9, currently the beta version. I implemented the PlayKnight 9 specific changes needed concerning platforms, because now we can have multiple platforms. I added some other features which I will show, like being able to add your HTML page to your phone as an application, which will look like an application. I added a new template, the table template, which will work much faster on a phone and is also handy on a PC. I fixed a couple of bugs, like sometimes it was not possible to click on a link in the details page. And that was due to a wrong template, an error in the template. I also added the tag as an export page, as a group field. So now you can export pages with your tag from games. Also fixed the library field, not always available in templates. I added a viewport for better viewing on phones. Also, the age rating, region, and platform fields are no longer sort fields, which means you can still sort on them, but as a group. So you have to group on them, and then you have to then you select normally a sort field, and there you can no longer select a platform, region, or age rating. If you had some pages that used that, but normally you don't, normally you sort on name or so, it won't work anymore. So in PlayKnight, in PlayKnight, the beta, everything is still more or less the same. Sorry, there's a wrong section in add-ons. So this is still the same page. The only thing that changed is you can now select a group field tag for a page, as you can see here. And here you can see I added revert to table requires images and revert to table text only. Those are completely new templates, and I mainly made them to be able to use them on a phone. Because the other templates, if you have a lot of games, especially the list one, will take a very long time on a phone to load. At least on my very old phone, so the pages themselves download quickly, but the rendering takes a long time on my phone. So let me first show you the table export. So I revert to table require images. Okay, I save, I export. So it's exporting, but I already did this so I can show it to you directly on my web page. So let me go to it. So this is the table export. As you can see, it's basically a table, but the main aspect of it is it only loads or only displays what's visible on the screen. So it doesn't load a table from 2000 or 3000 game entries, like here, and that makes it fast. It only loads about 12 rows per time. As you can see, I also made the buttons, the text, more clear, because on a phone, it looked very dark, and you could not really tell without zooming in what the labels were. So if I click on a game, you can see a very small image of the cover, and here you can click on the name to go to the details page. I also made the links here more clear to be able to see them better. Let me go back. You can also double click to get to the same page. And here sometimes the links were not working, but I fixed that. So basically you can scroll, you can sort. So if I select, let me see, play count, it will sort by default on that list on your sorting, but you can also change the sorting here. There is, however, a problem with certain fields. For example, if I choose edit, it doesn't know it's a date, and it will treat it as a string. So it will sort it as a string, and I cannot do much anything about that, so that will remain. You can also, for example, let me go back to name. You can filter on the name on the fields, for example, Mario, and it will list everything with Mario, Interstellar Marines, or GTA, Grand Theft. I'm not sure whether it's Grand Theft Auto. As you can see, it's really fast, especially in Windows on a normal browser. And you can select some games, and you see you always have one field here, which will change depending on what you select in the groups here. Those fields are always visible. On a phone, less data will be visible. The columns will hide themselves based on how small the screen is. But I will show you the phone version very soon. I will first explain you how it all works. So yeah, that's basically the new template. I also have a version without icons, so just the text, like this one, and you get the same info except no images, no covers, and also on the details page there's no images. These images are loaded from the internet, so that's different. And it works the same, so text only and copy images version. So now let me go to the phone. So I have these same pages on the phone. I will first show you what the problem was with the previous templates. The grid template on my phone takes a bit of time, but as you can see here, it's still loading, still loading, still loading, and my phone is not very fast. So it takes a while before the page is loaded and before you can actually view your data. So the grid one works, it's now done. But when you go back, and you take the list one, and I have about 2700 games, you will see it loads a very long time, at least on my phone. Also, if you start scrolling, some of the text may not be visible. Yeah, I cannot scroll fast enough. But as you can see here, because it's still loading the table, so that's not really fast. I did improve it a bit by making sure the table did not reposition itself. So the columns are fixed now, but as you can see, it's still loading and it takes a very long time. So that's why I made the table templates. As you will see, that loads much faster if I can get it to load. So I do the table, it's loading and it's loaded. And every data is here and you can scroll. The scrolling on my phone, it's a bit slow also. I mean it takes a while for it to load the extra data. But you can scroll as far as you want, and it will load that data. And the same thing works as on the PC. You can select a game. So if I select a game, it will change the info below in the small table, and you can click on the name to view the details of the game, and you can go back. If you go back, it won't select it again, it will load the table again. I cannot do anything about it because it's static HTML. What also works is, for example, if I select a game and I click on PC, Windows for platform, it will filter it will then go to the platform page. And it will filter everything on PC Windows. You can always clear the filter afterwards and view everything again from the platform. So you can browse some of your games. For example, if you have, I have single player, I want to see all my single player games, you click on it and it will automatically list only the games with as feature single player. So that's really nice. You can also search for a game, let's say name. Of course, it's now searching for single player and won't find a thing. And then you can search for, as I showed earlier, Mario. And it will filter on it. The reason it displays its both time is because the Super Mario World has a multiplayer and a single player feature. So that's why it's listed twice. Each feature is listed separately. The same happens now for platforms also. If you have a game with multiple platforms, it will list it as with multiple platforms in the list and in the details page. But if you go to the platforms page, you get each platform separately and the game will be duplicated. That's normal, that's how it's working. It happened also in the list view and the grid view. Also, as you can notice, not all columns are visible, but if I rotate my phone, hang on. So I rotate my phone, the screen will reposition itself and you can scroll a bit down to view the table. And as you see, there are now more columns visible. And you can again select them, you can clear the filter and see more info. So this is nicer to browse. Oh, I use my scroll wheel. So you can scroll in it using the touch. So yeah, as you can see, it's also much more clearer on the phone. If I go back to this view, it adapts the screen. So that's the new template. What I also added, for example, let me go to name, is an option to, not all browsers support this, but I think Firefox and Chrome definitely do, is you can choose add to home screen. So when you do this, you get a new, you can give it a name, and it will load an icon for it. So I have set the default to my game collection, but I will change the name to MGC table toevoegen. I add. And now when I go to my home screen, let me go to my home screen. There is MGC table. And when you double click that, it looks as if it's an app on the phone. So basically the web page loads full screen. And you have much more space to display things. The table won't expand. I cannot do that. I have to support many phone resolutions. But if you rotate the phone again, it will also work. And you have a better view of the data. So it looks as if it's an app on the phone, but it's basically a web page opening in full screen. And you can scroll again. So yeah. So yeah, that's on the phone, the new features. So by now PlayNight should have exported my images, my games. Let me go to the location. I will show you the platform stuff. So as you can see, new game, which I added as a test. I have to select name here. Oh, it's text only here. This was not it, it's that normal table. So if I select new game normally, I prepared it. Yeah, as you can see in the lists, also on the other templates, all platforms are listed like this. But if you go to the details, every platform is listed separately and then you can click on them also to view them, at least on the details page. Unfortunately, I cannot do it in all templates directly when clicking on them, but at least here it lists them separately. Same for the tags. Let me search one for the tags. So tag. What if it's tag? Let me sort reversed. So the tags are now displayed also, as you can see here in the, on the bottom. And if I clicked on any of the tags, it will again also load only that tag. That's what's really new. And the platform stuff is because Playnet 9 added multiple platforms per game. The age rating, in theory, you can now also have multiple age ratings per per game, and it will do the same thing for the age rating. So list them multiple times. Also on the details page, but I don't have a game with multiple age ratings set. At least I don't think I do, but I don't. So for the rest, I fixed a couple of bugs, as mentioned on my GitHub page. So let me check if I forgot something. Yeah, the links, the table, the tag. I already said that. Yeah, it doesn't check. Also, it doesn't check anymore on every function call to see if exception magic. Sorry, if image magic is installed. It used to do that every call, and it introduced some slowness. So now it should be faster to export your images. I can check if I had some more things, but it was mostly fixes for the table, the table template. Maybe. Yeah, the file deduplicator is also per image type now, because it could introduce some problems in the previous version, where if you had the same the same image used for cover and icon, it wouldn't display one of them. And now by using a deduplicator per image type, it does list them. So I also fixed GIF images. They didn't work when converting images, and that was mainly due to image magic generating multiple files from them, but I know how to fix that, and that's fixed also. So yeah, this is the new HTML exporter for Playnet 9. You can normally find it in the add-ons section if you browse to generic and then search for it, but I still have to upload it, so now it won't be visible. And the settings are also in add-ons generic HTML exporter. They are basically the same, just as the new options from version 2 here. I don't think I added any special things here, only some fixes or so. So yeah, that's the new HTML exporter for Playnet 9. I hope you like it and have fun.